Hey outdoors fans, today I'm going to review my Naturehike CloudUp1 tent, also Hannah Fly5 sleeping mate and Naturehike CW300 sleeping bag. Also I have a pillow from Naturehike. This is my bikepacking home, everything is new, I haven't used them yet, therefore feedback can be surprising. The tent and the mat fit into the handlebar bag and I carry a sleeping bag in a saddle bag. So the tent. It's a single type, double layer tent. There is the simplest and cheapest option with 210T polyester material, waterproof 3010 and floor. There are the least values for comfort. The size of the tent is 295 cm by 110 cm. The sleeping place is 210 by 110. Weight is 1.7 kilos. Here is the tent. And the footprint mat goes separately. It is must to use. It will protect the tent and your butt from getting too wet if it's raining or you set up the camp in a wet place, and also from stones or something else that can interfere with sleep. There is a set. External tent, internal tent, bags, poles. The bag is not compressible, and if you want to reduce it, then pack the poles separately in an in-frame bag, and the tent will take up less space. The wall package including the poles is 45 by 12. Let's set up camp. We spread the mat. It needs 5 pegs. Pegs of bright color. You wouldn't lose them in the grass, but they are very inconvenient to hit. You need to look for a stone or other device that will perform the function of a hammer. It is hard to hit pegs even into soft ground with hands or feet. We stick poles, everything is simple with them. They can be put together incorrectly. Insert them into the holes. Now we set up the inner tent. We cling to the poles through the belt loops. Snaps on easily. Now we set up the top tent. We snap to the main fasteners and install stretch marks with pegs. That's it, inside the tent. Sleep with the head towards to exit, that's how it's designed. There are small pockets on the left and right side of the head. Under the ceiling there is a hook for a lamp, two ventilation holes above the entrance and above the feet. Everything is covered with mosquito nets. Now the mat. It doesn't have a pillow to inflate, but it's not a problem. The mat is inflated literally in a couple of exhalations. By the way, the mat came with glue and a patch for repairs if you haul it. That's it. And a sleeping bag. It's made down 300G, 750 FP, and 90% goose down. There is a 3-season sleeping bag, but more summer. Comfortable temperature 9 degrees, minimum 4 degrees for this model. There are models more frost resistant, but I ride a bike and don't use it in the winter. And size matters to me. Its weight is 630 grams, packing 29 centimeters by 13 centimeters. But you can squeeze even more because the bag from the sleeping bag is compression. The sleeping bag itself is 200 centimeters by 80 centimeters. Well, I spent the night and I can describe some conclusions. There is not enough space inside the tent. You can't hide much stuff in it. Pegs. You just can't hit them in the ground. You pull it out by simply pulling the cord. This must be my pain. Each tent comes with assembly instructions, but I need instructions to how to pack it back into the bag. I need to repeat this at least 5 times so that the tent folds as it should. Under light rain in the evening, it doesn't leak anywhere and everything is dry inside. Mat. Very comfortable. If you press with your finger, you would reach the ground, but when you lay down, there are no remarks that is taught. Very comfortable. Sleeping bag. It was 8 degrees by Celsius at night. It was quite comfortable. I slept in shorts and a fleece jacket. Didn't freeze at all. So up to 4 degrees in thermal underwear, I'm sure, no problem. The sleeping bag is warm and pleasant to the touch. The zipper works without any problems and hasn't been jammed anywhere. General impressions. Doubtful opinion. Tent, I would take more for 2 people. It's not heavier, but there would be more space for stuff in it. I would look for a model with better pegs, and while the behavior during heavy rain, it's not clear. Sleeping mat. Definitely yes. There is nothing more to say. Sleeping bag. Opinion yes, if you don't get cold at night. And more than 4 degrees, then the sleeping bag is excellent. Small and light. If you need a warmer option, then choose another. But keep in mind, it will be heavier and bigger. About prices, I got it like this tent, 88 euros, mat 42 euros, and sleeping bag 114 euros. Yeah, you also saw a pillow. It's also from Naturehike. This is a great option. Folded crumb can be inflated for comfort, and it costs 12 euros. Good luck! See you in new videos!